What's going on, dreamers? In this video, I'm going to show how to make grass move out of the way as your character walks onto it, as you see right here. It's a pretty cool effect, a little expensive in the gameplay thermo department, but I still think this is a pretty cool thing, so I wanted to show you how to do it. So first off, let's delete literally everything. So I'm going to double tap X and press triangle. And now we're back to zero. Let's add like a base ground to do everything on. Now we want to make a little grass patch. The reason we can't just fill this entire thing with strokes is because there's a limit on how many strokes you can use. So we're going to place a stroke down. First, let's place a little like pad for our, a little base for our grass. This will be invisible. Okay, so we're gonna place the grass on this. You want to make each grass pad relatively small. We can probably do it bigger than this though. Maybe like that. If we make it too big, then we'll hit the physical stroke limit. So want to try to avoid that. But okay, so we're going to be making it on this. Now we want to place a stroke directly in the middle. Now we can't, unfortunately, we cannot use the grass stroke. And I mean, let me just show you why. And the reason it doesn't work is because it's only one stroke. For this stroke to become physical and to actually work, it needs to be multiple strokes. Okay, so oh boy. Hopefully you see why this isn't what we're doing. It's just not, if you can get it to work, that's awesome, but I wasn't able to. So what we're gonna do instead is make our own blade of grass. And to do that, we are going to use heavy. We're gonna make it green. We want it to get thick and then thinner as we go. Oh, maybe the pencil is what we want. Something like that. I didn't do this in the intro, but it's what I should have done. So this looks like a blade of grass, and you can do it as however you want, but what's important is that the stroke needs to be multiple flex. It can't just be a single flex. It has to be multiple flex. So now if we go into physics, make it physical, and increase the wind, you'll see how it's actually like blowing, and we definitely want it to, I mean, we're not gonna have wind, but yeah. So you can see how it's like moving, all right? Now, this is all like obvious. You probably knew this already. If you didn't, well, you learned something, but here's the first trick. So how do we make this a patch of grass? Well, you can manually copy and paste it, or you can go to clone. We want it to be on a plane and we want it to be around a cylinder. If we're not around a cylinder, they're all facing the same way, and that's not what we want. So like that. Obviously we want to decrease the spread, so we want it to be a little bit past the pad, just a little bit past, so it tiles better. And definitely scale jitter. Here's the trick. So watch what happens if we do, well, okay, that's not really what I'm referring to, but I mean, you'll notice how, okay, actually this is a good example. When I put the wind up, notice how it's not flowing in the direction of the wind. That's because we're using clone. Now, don't undo it. We still need to do that. But there's something else we need to do. But just to like really show that this doesn't work without making a change, let's get the character. And all I did for the character, by the way, is add a force applier to the character. Like so, a spherical one, and oh, actually it was a cylindrical one. That probably does not matter, but. And we obviously want this at the center of the character, and we want it to match the height of the character, like that. Zero for zone size, and we want it to be fall off. We want the zone to be fall off because we want it to be more forceful as you get towards the center. And let's just make it 5/5 for now. Okay. And finally, we want it to affect... We can just, let's make it affect scenery objects. It really doesn't matter. Just do whatever you want, but all selected. And then finally, force speed on strokes. And let's make it about 80 strength. Okay. And then the defaults push and radial is what we want. Okay, finally, we need to make these strokes scenery object. Okay, now we can actually test this. Okay, so notice how... It only gets affected when we hit the center, and two, they all go the same way. Like they all move as one, right? They all move as one. Here's the first really, really cool trick. If you have a single stroke and you clone it with, like, you do the duplicates page and you do duplicates, then you click it, you can merge those duplicates like that. And now if we go back, it's gone. We have no more clones because now all those duplicates have become their own individual stroke. And this is a really, really cool way to basically like make those duplicates real strokes. So now if we go, look at that. They all act as their own. And I mean, basically the tutorial is done, right? But no, not exactly. So there's your grass. But again, tutorial's not finished. Why did we make it a little patch? Let me just group these together, by the way. Why did we make it a little patch? There we go. So like, why can't we just fill the entire field like this? Well, we might be able to, but I don't think we will. Highly doubt we will. And that's why. Physical paint limit reached. So I hit a limit. There are too many physical paintings visible at once. And obviously, like, it's working. And yeah, so like this looks really good, but dreams can't handle it. So what do we do? Well, there was a reason we made it a little patch. We're going to add, so let's only make these strokes physical. Let's only turn this on if the character is nearby. So there are a bunch of ways to sense if a character is nearby. You can use a zone on the character. You could use a zone on the patch. You could use some sort of collision. But we want to do it in the most thermo-efficient way possible. So let's scope into this. Let's just place a chip in space. So now this chip is grouped in. And what do we want to do? Honestly, I didn't do this in the intro, but now that I think about it, the collision might work. Let's see if that works. Yeah, that didn't work. All right, fair enough. It was worth a try. There probably is a way to get the impact sensor working, but I'm going to go with the zone route. How do we do that? Well, all we need is a zone. That's pretty much it. Let's make the zone the same shape as our patch. And by the way, feel free, please, like I would actually highly recommend doing this. Make the patch of grass not a square. I'm doing it as a square because it's just easiest. But if you don't make it a square, if you make it like an irregular shape, so like, I don't know, I can't even think of something, but just a weird shape, it will tile better. So when you put them together, your brain won't notice the pattern. But like if I do this, I mean, yeah, you can actually, you can see the repeating pattern a little bit. We have a trigger zone. We need to be sensing the character. possess controller sensors, all controller sensors. Do whatever you want. Just something. I'm gonna do the label of friend, because I mean, potentially we want this to activate for maybe enemies as well, or maybe like other units as well. If you are doing that, just be careful not to hit the stroke physics limit. But yeah. Anyway, we're gonna do a friend, and then just hook it right in. There's some other stuff I'd like to do as well, but this is... I just ran off. This is a good start. The next thing we need to fix. Notice how it immediately snaps back like that right when we leave. That's kind of not okay. How do we solve that? Well, there's a couple of ways to go about this. The best way, the foolproof way, is to just increase this zone size. Another way to, but this way, you just have to be careful with this way, because there's a greater chance you'll hit the stroke physics limit. Another way is to add a timer. So basically once this turns off, this signal stays on for about a second later. The easiest way I've found to do that is with a signal manipulator. Output smoothing rise, we have it 0. Fall, we put it to about a second. And now all we do is, if this value is greater than 0, we output. And to save some thermo, we're gonna get rid of the node. So what this is doing is, whenever the signal coming out of the signal manipulator is greater than 0, it makes the strokes physical. Because the fall is a 1 second smooth fall, after this turns off, after it turns on, then turns back off, we will have a greater than 0 value coming out of this signal manipulator for a second. So now, if we run into it and then sprint out, it stays physical for a second. So that's what we're going for. You'll notice how we're not hitting the stroke physical limit, because only this little area has physical strokes. And we can run, we can go really fast. So, okay, yeah. Notice how if we run, you'll actually notice if we like run diagonally, it's not working because we're hitting the stroke physical limit. So as I said, we have to be careful with this zone size. I'm going to bump it down to that. And I'm also going to make this stay on for 0.5 seconds instead of 1 second. So let's copy and paste it again and try again. If your character is very fast, and notice how we're not hitting the limit anymore. Notice how the grass is always getting pushed away. If your character is very fast, you will activate too many of the grass pads and you'll hit the limit. So be wary of that. Anytime your character like interacts with the environment, it makes you feel more a part of the world, and that's exactly what this does. Now, I'm not gonna sit here and say like, you need to use this in your game, you use it for everything. No, this is a pretty niche technique, admittedly. Maybe you have patches of tall grass in places. Maybe it's like a stealth game or something. I think this would be a pretty cool effect. Pokemon comes to mind. If you have a large open world, you can't do this. I just have to say, like, you can't do this. It's just too much thermo. This little thing is 4% thermo. If we group this together, it's 64 different objects plus a bunch of logic. So like, we have this there. So we have that. We probably just hit a paint limit, right? Oh, physical paint. That doesn't make any sense. Why are they physical? Yeah, wait, that limit, that didn't make any sense. They shouldn't have been physical. That was a little thermo bug there. Am I going to fall right through? No. So, like, this patch of grass, which I don't think it's that big, frankly, that's 13% thermo. This is 13% thermo. Now, yes, it's all interactable grass, but this is not much. So use this technique sparingly. But I'd say if you do find a place to use it, it's a really, really cool touch. And I just want to show that it works for shorter grass and longer grass as well. So I'm going to really quickly make some of that. And literally, it's just you just make the stroke shorter or longer. All right, so I just made a patch of small grass and a patch of tall grass. Super quick note, you probably noticed let me undo the fix I made. You probably noticed when you get right on the edge of one of the patches, it'll just snap back. So, like that. To avoid that, what I would recommend doing is just making the fall off 0.1. This works very well on the medium and tall grass. Notice how we can stand right here and there's no snapback. On the short grass, I wouldn't do this. One, you probably won't even notice the snapback because it's so small. And two, it's so short that you barely even see it moving at all. So for the short grass, I would use this. And for the tall grass, I'd use this. And if you have a combination of both, something you could do is have two four suppliers. One four supplier for the scenery object tag, label combo, and one for scenery machine or any combo you want. So this one is the bigger one. This one can be scenery machine. And for the tall grass, we want it more narrow, right? So this one's more narrow. This one's bigger. The more narrow one, we want scenery object. So now, there's no snapback. But for the short grass, we don't care about that. So we use the bigger four supplier. So yeah, that is how you fix that issue. One last thing before I copy and paste these a bunch. I forgot to tell you guys to do this. Effects. All the effects look like garbage for this, except Throb. So I would highly recommend Throb. I know it looks kind of weird right now, but in a field, this looks pretty good. Probably you're thinking like, Acer, why don't you just put the wind on? Well, I mean, that's what I'd like, but remember, they're only physical if you're near them. This effect applies everywhere. So let's make a couple fields. So here we go. Here's some short grass. That was weird. All right, whatever. So here's some short grass. It's admittedly subtle, but I don't know. It looks pretty good. And then taller grass and tallest grass. Yeah, let me know how you guys use this, because it's pretty cool. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I hope it helped. If you want some dreams help or additional dreams help, check out my Discord. The link is in the description. It's a great place to ask for dreams help. Another cool place is my Twitch stream. I stream dreams on Twitch every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, sometimes Saturdays, sometimes Sundays. If you want some help, just stop on by and ask me live, and I'll help you out. Hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a great rest of your day. I just want to be with you. I just want to be